The following plays are under review.
Welcome to Under Review. I'm Logan.
I'm Mike.
And this is a new segment we're doing about, we are two officials through yes. USA Hockey, and we would like to talk about some of the officiating decisions that are made in the NHL.
Yes. Right now, there's a lot of skepticism as well as a lot of controversy regarding the calls made by certain officials in NHL games today. So we're going to go through a lot of these goals that are overturned or just challenged via the Situation Room, and we're going to go through and give us our opinions, what the rules actually say. Kind of just depends on what for each situation, I guess you could say. But we're going to try and go through as many as we can, and then hope you guys get a better idea of what the reasons that it's being called and kind of our from our standpoints as officials.
Yes.
You don't understand and respect the job unless you have actually done the job. And
from true
being,
that.
From being a former player, I mean, how is it different?
You have a lot more of a respect for an official once you become an official, because there is so much going on that you don't even think about when you're playing. You're just standing there yelling at the guy, and you don't know what is going through his head and what he's thinking about.
Mm-hmm.
He's thinking about 18 different things at the same time, in addition to watching the play to mm-hmm. see what's going on.
Especially at the speed of the games that we're doing now,
yes.
our midget majors, minors, and stuff. There's a lot going on now that we sometimes have split duties, whether you're linesman or referee. There's still a lot going on that you have to watch for. I mean, it's a tough job, but I mean, it's a lot of fun if you get a good game.
Oh, yeah. And you're never going to be appreciated by everybody. As long as you understand that, no matter what you call, someone's always going to be mad at you. And once you kind of... Except for yourself. You get what I'm saying.
It's a hard job, but there's a lot of rewarding parts to it. So.
Oh, yes. All right. Let's get right into it. All right,
so our first situation comes from the Montreal versus Pittsburgh game today.
Was that today?
It says the 21st.
That was today. Today
okay,
is the 21st. So,
The Montreal Canadiens challenge Evgeny Malkin's goal for potential goaltender interference, but the video review confirms that the goal... in the first period.
Let's watch the video first, and then we'll talk about
okay.
what happened.
Right off the faceoff, a shot stop, rebound, Price scrambling, puck goes in, they score! Evgeny Malkin and Patrick Hornquist right there in the blue paint. Pittsburgh opening the scoring tonight.
And there's a rule, I believe it's 69.2, that situation. You cannot push both the puck and the goalie in the net at the same time. Let's see what we got here. We'll take another look at it. Off that faceoff that Drouin was upset about. Price loses balance. There's the one hand on the stick. But Price is out completely out of position. The puck is in the blue paint. Now, you're allowed to go in there. But did Malkin, by pushing the netminder in there, who was turned away from the puck, could not see it anyways. That's a tough one.
After review, it's confirmed as a good goal.
Okay, great explanation by the referee right there. So what I kind of got from this situation is that there was an initial shot on mm-hmm. the net that Carey Price stopped. Then Malkin dived in.
Dove
into the netminder. But he made contact with the puck first, so it was a shot, and then his follow-through of like his body mm-hmm. went into the goaltender, and then as the puck is in the air, it went off of him and into the net.
I don't think he really impeded the progress of Carey Price to make the save at all. Mm-hmm. I mean, he was already laying flat on his back. He really had no chance to save that anyway. So
that's a tough one, though.
Yeah.
That's a tough one. All right. So you agree? Good goal?
I do agree. Good goal.
Okay. All right. So, moving on to our next situation. This is from Philadelphia versus the Detroit Red Wings. This was yesterday. Video review shows that...
March 20th.
Yes. Travis Konechny, goal in the third period, crossed the goal line before the net was...
He'll find DeKaiser, but he couldn't handle it. McDonald has it. He'll
get to Konechny. Konechny across Couturier to Giroux, right back to Couturier. Couturier in front! It's in! Oh, the net came off! I thought the puck was in the net before it came off. Konechny thinks he has a goal, but they wave it off. It was waved off immediately by referee Brian McMurray.
Never touched it with, I don't even think he knew where it was when he was driving the net, but it's clearly in before the net came off.
I believe we have a tie hockey game.
I believe we do too.
That looks like a goal for me, guys.
It didn't hit his skate, and it didn't appear to be directed in with his glove. No, it happened too fast. It was ripped, it was deflected up off of him and in before he knew where it was.
After video review, the puck crossed the goal line before the net came off, therefore we have a goal.
So I think he thought that the net came off before the puck went in. I mean, clearly the puck was in the net before he ran into it. There was really no thought about that one.
Yeah, I agree with it. I know in international rules, I don't know what it is, but I know if the puck goes in and the net comes off, but it doesn't have any impact on whether it would be a goal or not, the goal stands. But I don't know in terms of this situation. It says right here, according to Rule 78.4, the goal frame shall be considered in its proper position when at least a portion of the flexible pegs are still inside both goalposts and the hole in the ice. So you saw, as the puck was going in, the net was coming up, but you could still see the pegs, and they're in the ice, so that's considered still part of the goal. So I guess that was part of the reason for their goal call.
Yeah.
I mean, easy call. Nothing really to dispute over that one. I thought that was a good goal.
I agree. Good goal.
Our next situation comes from the Dallas versus Washington game, also March 20th. I'm not going to read the description. We're just going to kind of find out what happens.
Vrana double-teamed along the dasher. Connolly hoping to skip free there. Radulov had other ideas. Long-range score! Lettinen is complaining that it was hit with a high stick. The Caps grab the lead.
He thought Connolly caught it in the high slot here, and the referees will huddle up, and the referees will discuss it.
After video review, the call on the ice is confirmed. Goal.
Okay.
I'm fairly certain that went off the defender, not the offensive player. If you look closely, I did not see contact.
I thought it originally went off of Dallas's stick. But
on the initial shot you're talking about from the blue line?
Yes.
Okay.
So he shot it, and then Dallas's player had to stick up high like this. I think there might have been contact there. I mean, we can go back and watch it.
Yeah, let's watch it real quick.
From this
so you're talking about this guy right here?
This guy right here.
Oh, no, I think it hit this guy.
This guy?
Yeah, right, in front of the net there.
All right.
Right? Oh, well, maybe not. He's zoomed down a little bit.
That is a tough one.
Yeah, let's watch.
I think this is our best angle right here.
Which one? Yeah, that one.
I can't.
Okay.
I think it hits Connolly, though.
I don't think it does.
You don't think so?
No.
I feel like it kind of moves. You see it kind of going to the right.
Let's watch the next angle here. Watch. Right here. Right? It does not. Oh. I don't know.
Okay.
I mean.
All right. I guess I thought I saw a high stick or some sort of contact with the defenseman or the forward from Washington.
Obviously, the Situation Room did not think so.
So, I don't know. I guess we're going to have to go with the referee's discretion. And then again, the NHL in Toronto, they do have more angles than we have available via NHL.com.
And either way, that the first angle we saw from behind the defender, I didn't think that was necessarily above the crossbar to begin with.
True.
So it's really, that's a hard one to tell.
All right. Moving on. All right. Next we have Florida versus Montreal. Again, another Montreal one.
Whew. Controversial.
Yes, this is from March 19th, so a day before that.
Came in the zone 1-on-3 and was able to hold it and wait for the help. Here's Lekkonen in for Montreal. Wrap around attempt and they score. De La Rose off the feed and the Canadians answer right back seconds later. They are going to challenge this for offside, I believe.
Florida is using their coach's challenge for offside.
So this is huge. It's either 1-1 on a Montreal power play or the Panthers maintain their lead. Here's a look. You know, you don't see these often. The offside challenges, now that you get a penalty if you lose it, not just lose your timeout, are way down in the league. The Panthers video assistant coach, Ben Cooper, said to the bench, obviously, hey, go ahead, challenge it.
After video review, the call has been reversed. It was offside.
There you go. Wow. Yeah, that is a tough call. But again,
great challenge.
Your thoughts?
He was offsides. I mean, clear, we saw that in that last angle from across the blue line. His skates, blades specifically, were over the blue line before the entire puck had crossed. Good call, I think, in my opinion. What do you think?
I agree with you. I have nothing. I think it's a good goal.
Good goal. Or yes. Good call.
Good call.
I All guess right. Not good goal. That was
next up, we have the Chicago Blackhawks versus the St. Louis Blues.
Yes. We saw this. I enjoy this one.
All right. We already
Rodziak sends behind the net. Murphy is on it there for the Blackhawks. Now Hayden with just over two remaining in the period. Pass nearly intercepted by Shen. Dunn flips it ahead for Braden Shen. Leaving it for Schwartz. A shot gets behind the goaltender for Ruby, and it's knocked in.
The referee called a goal. That's Ian Walsh. He called a goal. Did it cross all the way across the line? Ooh, that's tight. I don't see that clear across. Let's watch it again. The entire puck needs to cross. That is so close.
After review, the puck never crossed the line completely. No goal.
No white in between the red and the black, and
it's very close.
It's
though.
Toothpick width of the
you couldn't slide
goal
a piece
line.
Of paper.
You could not. It is very close, but it didn't fully cross the goal line, and you can't. I mean, you can't say that's a goal.
But you can't get any closer than no goal on that. I mean, it's just. Barely there. The argument is, oh, you can see white because the puck is so far over the red line or on top of the red line where you could see the white kind of coming around the puck, but not completely. You know
right.
what I mean? So,
right.
I also agree, no goal.
Okay.
Because the puck never went across the goal line. And it has to be conclusive. You have to see white in between. If you can't just assume...
like if his glove or blocker in this case was yeah. covering it.
I'm still surprised how he was able to like squish it between the stick and the blocker and then push it out.
I'm still surprised how that got behind him in the first place, but that's for a different video.
That's a different type of video. All right, moving on. We have Montreal versus Toronto, March 17th.
All the Leafs are getting shots. Here's Hainsey with one. Lindgren stopped it. Loose puck. Score.
Montreal is challenging. There was goaltender interference before the goal.
Is Juleson the one that knocks him in or not? I think Juleson lost body position, and Plekanec is in that blue crease. And look at Lindgren right away. He's barking back to the official that there should be that interference with the elbow on the head.
What do you think?
No goal. I think there's goalie interference on the play.
Yes, for sure. I think whoever, I don't know because I paused the video, but the player that was in the crease is definitely hindering the goaltender's ability to make the save right there. And he's kind of falling on top of him, kind of has his arm, not in a headlock, but very close. So let's see what they call it.
I do not think he was pushed. I don't know what you think. I don't think he was pushed.
I mean, you stand right in the middle of the crease, which you can't do.
Right.
So let's see what the call is.
After review the play, that was a goaltender out there, Prince. No goal. Montreal took the timeout.
I would have to agree with that.
Oh.
As you can see, Plekanec is definitely in the middle of the crease, both skates inside, making contact with Lindgren. Really not too much to deliberate about.
I mean, that is a good, solid example of goaltender interference.
Yeah, absolutely.
On a side note, for as far as goaltender interference goes, the GMs just had a meeting about goalie interference, and they, I don't know if it's confirmed yet if they're going to, or when this is going to be implemented, but the goalie interference calls will now all be decided by the NHL Situation Room. Your thoughts on that?
It's gonna happen. I mean, it happens right now. If it's not challenged by the coaches, then it automatically already goes to Toronto. So it's gonna be the same thing. They're taking it out of the referee's hands, and it will be in Toronto who has the final say.
And I think it'll provide more consistency throughout all the games instead of different guys having different opinions on what goalie interference is. Now it'll just be the set group of guys in the Situation Room making all the calls. So good for the NHL on that one.
Yep. All right.
Continue. Sorry.
Our next situation is Nashville versus Colorado on March 17th.
Andrew Ghetto with speed. That one hit the outside of the cage. Sent back in front. Soros to save. He's down. Puck loose. And there's the whistle. Just a scramble. Full-out scramble. You can see the traffic in front. Look at his edge work. He's able to get back and go all the way across the net back into position. Now he's just in full battle mode, trying to hunt that puck down. He's got pressure. Guys coming in, trying to jam him in the net on the doorstep. Battling, coming in here late and just trying to pitchfork UC Soros into the net. No goal.
So I'm not sure if the puck ever did cross the goal line, so I don't know how you can call goalie interference if the puck never crossed the goal line. But let's just say that the puck did go over the goal line. I would say no goal as a result of the player coming in and pushing the goaltender along with the puck into the net, which you cannot do.
Yes,
because of a rule.
Because of a rule that does exist, I promise.
So would you agree with that?
I agree. Good goal. All right. So final one here.
Final one. We have San Jose versus Calgary on.
Gill takes it away and fires it ahead. Meyer in. Slows it down. Drops it off Tierney. Meyer backhand stopped by Smith. They bat it in, but it's a high stick. Immediately waved off.
Tic-tac-toe passing here by the Sharks. There was a couple times that LeBanc and Meyer exchanged that puck. See, no question about it. A high stick. It comes right up high. Meyer's the guy who knocks it in, the official right there to wave it off. But there were two or three passes that the Sharks were allowed to do consecutively.
All right, so after review, it was blatantly obvious that it was knocked down with a high stick.
Yes,
no goal.
Clearly a foot or two above the crossbar there. Good call.
Yeah.
I think good call.
Most people don't know this, but in USA Hockey, it's different than the NHL. If you're in the NHL, it's the crossbar. You cannot make contact with the puck with your stick above the crossbar. That is then a high stick.
Yes.
For USA Hockey, the rule is if it's your shoulders, not the crossbar, unless you are taller than the crossbar.
Yes, I have run into that at least once that I can think of right now. I scored a goal. The stick was below my shoulders.
You didn't score a goal.
Well, okay, I did not. So the puck went into the net. The stick was above the crossbar, below my shoulders. My shoulders are a good foot or two above the crossbar. And the referee waved it off, and I was informed that my shoulders are above the crossbar, so the crossbar is the high stick limit. So good call in both instances.
Yes.
Real quick, one last thing. Steven Stamkos has been fined $5,000 for tripping Morgan Riley. What do you think about that?
It's a slew foot in the corner. It's a dangerous play, worthy of a suspension.
Yep.
Or not a suspension, sorry, a fine.
Yes. Yeah, I agree. I think.
So, moving on. This is pretty much the end of the episode. So, for the first time doing these videos, there's room for improvement. We know. Put down in the comments what you'd like to see, how many videos, different instances, if there's videos you want to see from the past.
What you like, what you don't like.
Yeah,
you know,
just give us some feedback. Like the video if you like it, and don't dislike it if you don't dislike it. So regardless, subscribe for more content. We have another podcast/show
on the same channel.
Yeah, that we cover just other NHL news and stuff that's going around in the league. And this one is strictly for referee stuff. So, with that being said, I guess we'll see you next time.
These plays have been under review.